Hello, I am Lisa Stubbe, and I am a fisheries biologist with the Alaska Department of Fish and Game. I am currently the Yukon River Management Biologist for the Division of Sport Fish. I will be talking about one of my favorite fish species in Alaska, the sheefish. If you happen to travel through Canada, these fish are also referred to as Inkanu. Also, if after you view this presentation, you want to learn more, these fish are also referred to as Inkanu in the scientific literature. Sheefish are members of the whitefish family and are distinguishable by the strong extended lower jaw. Similar to other whitefish, sheefish are known for having a high phenotypic plasticity. In non-scientific terms, sheefish have personality, as you will be shortly seeing. Sheefish are found in large northern rivers and associated lakes of northwestern North America and northern Eurasia. In Alaska, sheefish are found in the Yukon and Kuskokwim rivers, as well as rivers that flow into Kotzebue Sound, like the Kobuk and Selawik. Sheefish are a very important subsistence resource in Alaska and can get quite large. Sheefish are also sought after by sport anglers and are fun to catch by those who enjoy their large size and fighting spirit. For those of you who may have watched the old 1980s movie, Caddyshack, these words of wisdom can also apply to sport fishing for sheefish. Not that you want to conquer the fish or look like one, but rather you'll be more successful in fishing for any species if you understand more about their biology. Plus, sheefish have such interesting life history strategies. Studies have been conducted in the Yukon, Kuskokwim, Kobuk, and Selawik rivers utilizing radio telemetry techniques in order to better understand their biology. Basically, fish were anesthetized and then radio transmitters were surgically in place. The radio tagged sheefish were then tracked using stationary tracking stations that recorded the time and date that the fish swam past. And they were tracked using fixed wing aircraft with antennas mounted on each wing. From these studies, biologists were able to locate and document sheefish spawning areas, important summer feeding areas, and where they spend their winters and the timing of migration to these areas. As you can see, the Yukon, Kuskokwim, Kobuk, and Selawik River drainages pretty much cover most of the state, yet the radio telemetry studies have shown that sheefish spawn in very few and relatively small areas, which are triangles on this map. Between 2007 and 2015, I conducted a drainage-wide radio telemetry study on sheefish in the Kuskokwim River, and what I've learned here can also be applied to the Yukon River. In red are the four spawning locations, which are up in the upper drainage, which isn't many, given this is the second largest river in Alaska. And in pink is where many like to go to overwinter, usually in the lower river estuary. But some spend the winters in the main stem and large tributaries. And very important to you fishermen out there is in purple are the summer feeding locations, which you can see are typically at the mouths of pretty much all of the major tributaries. Sheefish are broadcast spawners that typically spawn during late September and early October. And depending on how far they have to travel, will sometimes take most of the summer to swim there. When they are done spawning, many head back to the lower river. Now for this presentation, I will be focusing on Yukon River sheefish. Currently, sheefish are known to spawn in six locations: the Upper Noko River, the Salukna River that's in the Upper Nuwitna River, the Lower Alatna River, the Yukon River flats above the confluence with the Porcupine River, and above Fort Yukon, and on the Tanana River, the Upper Chattanooga River, and the Tanana River main stem near Fairbanks. The Yukon River is much larger than the Kuskokwim River, and the Yukon flat spawning location, that uppermost one you see on this map, above the Porcupine River, is about 1,000 miles swim. And as I mentioned, many of these fish will spend their winters down in the Yukon River Delta. Imagine swimming 2,000 miles a summer. As you can see, spawning females have thousands of eggs, which, to be honest, when breaded and fried, are quite tasty. Now, traveling up to 1,000 miles upriver, one way fighting that current, can make any fish hungry. And there are many tributaries that drain into the Yukon River with opportunities to catch sheefish. For sheefish, these tributary confluences have eddies that are nice places for fish to stop, rest, and eat. So if you're boating up and down the Yukon or Kuskokwim rivers, you might pull off and marvel at the beauty of these tributary mouths as you're getting your fishing rods ready. But to a sheefish, these are more than just places to stop and rest on their 1,000-mile journey. They can also represent grand feasts. Far up, many of these tributaries may be spawning areas for other species like salmon. This particular sheefish was chowing down on out-migrating juvenile salmon during June and July. In this next example, sheefish were captured during late September from the lower Yukon or Kuskokwim, had stomachs full of 3 and 9 spine stickleback. Here, this pregnant looking sheefish that was captured in the lower river during late May, it wasn't actually pregnant. It was actually full of shiny rainbow smelt. So, good to use lures that look like shiny smelt and juvenile salmon, like this assortment of 2 to 3 inch pixies, crocodiles, and daredevils, especially for fish that you know may have been exposed to these delectables. With success. However, I remember fishing on the Chattanooga River near Fairbanks one time, and my shiny lures weren't attractive. So one of the people I was fishing with caught a sheefish, and I cut its stomach open and found some baby northern pike. Well, I then switched lures to baby pike and had success. Other shads to the right of the pike also worked well. Also look out for back eddies that are above the confluences of tributaries that you might further upriver, as these can also be good places to fish as they may concentrate juvenile prey. I've seen sheefish feeding frenzies at these back eddies where they open their large mouths and leap about filling their stomachs. It can be quite a sight. Because sheefish are relatively large, you will want to make sure your fishing rod can handle the weight. I like to use one that can accommodate 15 to 25 pound test fishing line. They don't have the sharp teeth that northern pike do, but still, I usually like to use a steel leader to help keep the line from breaking. Now, sheefish are slow growing, long lived fish, so please only harvest what you need. This is a photograph of a sheefish otolith, which is an inner ear bone that when collected in thin section can be aged like rings on a tree. This particular sheefish was 14 years old, but they can live into their 20s and 30s. And the oldest age so far was 42. So when catching and releasing sheefish, please take care to not cause any undue injury. The Alaska Department of Fish and Game website has a good brochure on proper catch and release techniques. Some of these include using a single hook and crimping down the barb, using a soft landing net, and keeping the fish in the water and taking your photographs quickly. Thank you very much for watching my presentation. Happy fishing.